Dear students, this is your lecture number 4 of your 12th chemistry unit number 1. In this video lecture, I am going to discuss about the basics of the crystal lattice. We'll try to understand what is the meaning of crystal lattice, what are the different kinds of crystal lattice we are having. Okay, so let's start with the lecture first of all. So what a crystal lattice actually represents? A crystal lattice actually gives you a pictorial representation, or you can say it gives you the information regarding the geometrical arrangement. And what are the geometrical arrangement? Geometrical arrangement of the constituent particles. Okay, so particles may be your atoms also, ions also, or molecules also, and in the space lattice. For example, if you hold anything in front of you, like you play the Ludo. Okay, in the Ludo that you have a that the dice in front of you. So in that, for example, if that dice represents a particular kind of your matter, then what are the constant particles of matter and how these matter, how these constant particles are arranged in that structure? So that is being represented by the crystal lattice, and it is named on the name of your Brevis lattice, the scientist who gave this concept of representing the crystal lattice. Okay, so let's as you can see from here that I have taken an example of NaCl, okay, the common salt. In this, as you can see that this yellow dot represents your sodium ion, and chlorine represents your and this blue color represents your chlorine minus ion. So this is the crystal lattice of your NaCl. Now crystal lattice, in the crystal lattice, what point is being to be understand? Let's try to understand first of all that in the crystal lattice, each point, okay, for example, if I again take the same example of common salt NaCl, so each point represents a constituent particles. Each point will present a particular, in fact, particular constituent particles, like a particular atom, particular molecule, a particular ion will be represented at a particular point. This is known as your lattice point. Okay, every point is known as your lattice point. Okay, this is your lattice point, and by joining the and by joining these lines or by joining these lattice points, we can find out the geometrical structure, or you can say the geometry of the lattice of that very particular matter. So this is a characteristic or general characteristic of your crystal lattice. Now moving towards your unit cell, what we understand from the term unit cell. So now see, cell means what? The smallest unit, okay, which represents itself, okay, in the complete structure. So the same way we can define in the chemistry also, that the smallest possible portion or the part of the crystal lattice which repeats itself, okay, in different direction of the lattice is called unit cell. As you can see in this case that in the complete structure, this structure, this part is being repeated everywhere. As you can see here, everywhere this part is being repeated. So this is your unit cell, and it is the point present on the unit cell are known as your lattice points. Okay, now characteristic, what are the characteristic of unit cell? Now it is you know that, as you have just seen that it's a three dimensional. So in the three dimensional, you'll have three three edges will be there, A, B, C, and if three edges are there, then three angles will be there, obviously. So as you can see in this diagram, this is the diagram of a unit cell in which you are having one edge A, this is your B, and this is your C, and the angle between A and C is taken as beta, A and B is taken as gamma, and C and B, the angle is being taken as alpha. This is common convention that we follow. Okay, now the classification or the existence of the lattice will depend upon this A, B and C, and this alpha, beta and the gamma. Okay, we'll see in the further discussion that now this A, B, C and alpha, beta, gamma, these parameters are going to decide that what will be the structure of your matter, or you can say the unit cell that we are having. In short, now see here, now we are having two types of unit cell. One kind of unit cell is that in which you have the constituent particle present at the corners only, as you can see in this, okay, in the corners only. So if you have this type of unit cell, then it is known as your primitive unit cell. And if the constant particles are present at the corners as well as in the center, like the in the center of the body, or on the every faces or on the every faces or on the end faces only. Okay, so these are known as your centered unit cell. So if the constituent particle is also present on the centered only, I am telling centered only, then at that time it will be known as your body centered. Okay, it is known as your body centered unit cell. And if the constituent particles are present on the end faces, okay, then these are known as your end centered. Okay, these are known as your end centered. And if the constituent particles are present on the faces also, it is known as your face centered. So different matter have a different kind of unit cell. I am having a tabular form of those examples also that I'll show you at the end of this video lecture. So these are the different types of unit cells that we have for a particular matter. I am saying for a particular matter. So if I, for an example, if I say that NaCl is having has primitive unit cell. So if you take NaCl anywhere or any sample, so you will take, you will have the primitive unit cell only. Okay, so you can say unique for each and every matter to exist in a particular kind of unit cell. Now the explanation has been written there, body centered, that I told to you that in this case the constituent particles are one of the constituent particle will be present at the center of the body and other constituent particles are located at the corners. Next one is your face centered, in which the constituent particles are present on each and every faces along with the corner. Please repeat, please understand, along with the corners. And end centered, along with the corners and on the two end faces, opposite end faces. Okay, now formation of lattice, we can understand. Now we are having what kind of the cubic lattice. Now cubic lattice again can have three types. One is your primitive like simple cubic, or body centered, or you have you can have the face centered. Okay, these three are the type of the cubic lattice. So in this case, now as I told you that, if you remember just now, I told you that ki A, B, C and the angles alpha, beta and gamma, these are going to play a very vital role in the formation of the lattice and the type of the lattice. Now if the matter has a cubic lattice, then in that case A is equal to B is equal to C will be there if it is cubic, and alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, sometimes this questions comes in the multiple choice questions also, okay, in the cubic lattice what is the relationship between the edges. So this is the relationship between the edges, and then again MCQ can be asked from you that in the cubic lattice what is the relationship between the angles between the edges. So alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, now moving toward the next type is your tetragonal. In tetragonal you have the possibility of only two, that is your primitive, means the constant particles will be present at the corners of the unit cell only, and second one is your along with the corner, one is present at the body also. So body centered and the primitive, most important part, in the tetragonal. Okay, one of the edge will not be equal to other one. What I mean to say, A is equal to B but it is not equal to C. So one edge is having a different length, but the angle alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma is equal to 90 degrees. This is the characteristic of your tetragonal lattice. So please remember all these parameters very carefully, because in the examinations or in the multiple choice questions, these questions can be asked from you. Now next part is your orthorhombic lattice. In the orthorhombic lattice, we are having all four types, like primitive, it can be primitive also, it can be end centered also, it can be body centered also, or it can be face centered too. As you can see, in the primitive, all the corners having the constituent particles, here the corners along with the body, here the corners on and on the faces, and here are the corners and the end of the faces here. And in this case also, you have lengths are unequal in nature, but your alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma is equal to 90 degrees. So in whatever we have seen in cubic, in tetragonal we have seen, and in orthorhombic we have seen that the angles are alpha, beta and gamma, and alpha, beta, gamma are 90 degree equal to each other. It means that all the edges are perpendicular to each other in case of your in case of your cubic, tetragonal and the orthorhombic. Next part is your monoclinic. Monoclinic, in this you have only two types, primitive and the end centered. So in primitive means every corner will have the constant particles, and here one more important thing is that it has also unequal sides, and one of the, not try to see here, one of the angle will not be equal to 90 degree. One of the angle means your alpha is equal to beta is equal to 90 degree, it may be there, but gamma may not be equal to 90 degree. One of the angle means any angle cannot be 90 degree. It's not a constant of the gamma only, but I have taken this thing as an for the purpose of illustration and an example, as you can understand from this. Okay, now the next part is a hexagonal lattice. In the hexagonal lattice, it has only one time kind, that is your primitive only, means it will be present at the corners only. So it has two equal sides, means third side will not be equal, and two angles are 90 degree and one angle is 120 degree, means alpha, in this case you can say alpha is equal to beta is equal to 90 degree, but gamma is equal to 120 degree. So if you have this kind of case, then it will be a hexagonal lattice. Sorry. Now rhombohedral. In the rhombohedral, it has also one kind, that is your primitive. All the corners will be occupied by the constant particles, and three edges are equal, but angles are not equal to 90 degree. Means the angles will be different. Alpha may be your 85, beta may be your 65, gamma may be other, but some of the, all these things will be equal to 180, but angles will be different, not equal to 90 degree. So if this type of lattice you are having, then it is known as your rhombohedral lattice. Now the last, now the second one is your next one is your triclinic lattice. In this also you have the primitive type. In this also, in this case you have unequal side. Now try to understand the difference. In the rhombohedral you have equal length, but in case of triclinic you have unequal length. And none of the angles between the faces of the triclinic are 90 degree. So you are not required to get confused. Although in the angle rhombohedral and the triclinic, they have the same relationship, means the angle will not be equal to 90 degree, but in terms of the sides of the length, in rhombohedral, as you can see, in case of your rhombohedral, the lengths are equal, but in case of your triclinic, lengths are unequal. So we have to understand these differences very carefully whenever we have to solve the multiple choice questions. Okay. Now, as I told you that in the last of the video lecture, I'll share with you the tabular form. Now you can see the tabular form. It will be helpful for you to remember. Cubic, it exists in the primitive, body centered and the face centered. All the edges are equal, angle equal to 90 degree, and examples most importantly, NaCl, copper, zinc sulfide. Tetragonal, it exists in the primitive and the body centered, A is equal to B, but it is not equal to C, and in this case also angle is equal to 90 degree, and the examples are white tin, SNO2, TiO2 and CaSO4, calcium sulfate. Orthorhombic, it exists in the primitive, body centered, face centered, end centered, and in this case A is not equal to B is not equal to C, as I told you, but the angle are equal. So in this case, as you can see, in these three cases angle are same, but the relationship between the edge length is different. So like your rhombic sulfur, okay, BSO4, potassium nitrate, all these things are you having. And hexagonal, it is only just in the primitive. In this case, like tetragonal, as you can see, like tetragonal, A is equal to B but not equal to C. In this case, two angles are compulsory to be 90 degree and gamma is equal to 120 degree. As an example, you have graphite, zinc oxide and CDS, cadmium sulfide. Okay, rhombohedral, primitive. In this case also you have A equal to B equal to C. In this case, angles are not equal to 90 degree. Angle may be any angle but not equal to 90 degree. Okay, like CaCO3, calcium carbonate, and then cinnabar, that is your HGS, mercuric sulfide. Okay, now this is your monoclinic, primitive and the end centered. A is not equal to B is not equal to C. Now this is the same. In this case, these, see here, orthorhombic and rhombo and the monoclinic have the same relationship in terms of your this one. Okay, You can see, but here in this case angle is alpha and gamma is equal to 90 degree, but beta is not equal to 90 degree. Example is sulfur, and the last one is your triclinic. It exists only in primitive. In this case also the sides are not equal and angles, as you can see here, not equal to 90 degree. Okay, like H3PO3, COSO4, H2O, as I told you na, ki different matter will have a different crystal lattice crystal structure that you have. Okay, in the last one, most important thing I want to discuss, all the same kind of conclusion has been drawn here, and you can memorize the things in this way also. But the main intention to show this slide is that now see here, what is the total number of Brevius lattice to be exist. Total number is 2 + 1 = 3, 4 + 3 = 7, 2 + 9 = 12 = 14, means total 14 lattice structure that you have. And this question is also asked in the multiple choice question also, that what is the total number of Brevis lattice we have. In total we have 14. The counting has been done from here only, as you can see. You can match this thing, beta. Now see, the thing is that in this case, as you can see, you can count primitive, body center and face center. It's a 3. Okay, it's a 2. And here 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, primitive you can take 1, you can take 1, you can take 2, you can take 1. Now when you add this one, 4 to 7, 3, 10. Okay, 4, 2, 6, 3, 9, 1, 10 and 4, 14. Okay, that table has been deduced from this thing only. So in this way you can understand that thing. Okay, so this was all about the crystal lattice and the classification. And in this video lecture I have discussed about the what are the different kinds of lattice structure you have, and how the lattice is being formed, and what is the relationship between their edges and the angle. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video, and take care of yourself.